Well, y'all, this is Jason, JC's Honeybees. Here we have an old abandoned trash can that the owner had punched holes in to allow for water drainage and for air escape when he put the bag inside. It is unknown how long the bees were in the can since the owner is deceased. But I will tell you, I had to cut some small trees down just to get to the trash can. And this trash can is very, very heavy. Before I do my removal on them, though, I've really enjoyed the novelty of having a trash can full of bees. And reminding myself of the little joke, one man's trash is another man's treasure. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to give you a few minutes of video with the trash can bees. I hope y'all enjoy it.
Thank you.
Okay, y'all, that's about 10 minutes with bees. I want to share with you just a little bit more. When people tell you you have to have your apiary set up a certain way with your hives getting either full sun or morning sun and afternoon shade and well ventilated and screen bottom boards and all that other stuff. This thing was sitting in the woods, buried about 2 inches in the ground. Would have originally been the top, but is now the bottom. It was buried about 2 inches in the ground. There's a couple of holes here. There were more, but when winter came, the bees propolized it up. So what I'm saying is, you know, what works for me may not work for you. What works for you may not work for me. You have to find what it is that works for both you and your bees, and there will be mistakes made along the way. Unfortunately, the novelty's kind of worn off, and I do need to get these ladies out of here. I will do that video later on. I'm in the state of Texas where I'm at. You're not supposed to have a colony of bees that aren't on frames that can be inspected. Archie, if you see this video, I do greatly appreciate these bees. They have been a real joy and not near as grumpy at my house as they were at yours. and y'all take care. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this didn't bore you to death.